Hello guys, this is Leo the Wise, giving to all men, their needed uprise.
Hello my dear crew, what's going on today in your lives? Hope that the way of your life, going your own way, free of all, is satisfying. If not it will be for sure, as it cannot be otherwise because you focus on yourself and let the world be like it will be anyway. I came to the website called returnofkings.com. Quite the red pill flavor. And there is a topic that I want to share with you regarding death. Stoicism is key here folks, it happens to all, no matter how great, rich, strong and healthy. We all go back to dust and for those not cremated, that is put in a box, we are some worms and pests delicious food at the end of our lives. To cope a bit with that vision, I would like to present 8 ways to deal with your future death. Enjoy. We never stop to think that our time here is limited. Unlike God, we are mere mortals whose lives are going to end one day. And the sad truth is that we never know when it's coming. For some, it will be a peaceful transition from the physical world to the spiritual world when you reach old age. To others, it will be a painful all of a sudden unexpected experience without a chance to say goodbye to their loved ones. NLESS you are in law enforcement, military, firefighting or any other life-threatening job. Chances are that you live your days never stopping to think that you have an expiration date just like the food you bought in the supermarket a few days ago. I'm not trying to make you sad or depressed. Unfortunately, that's just how life goes. Tomorrow I may die in a car crash, be run over by a car, killed by a bullet, contract a deadly disease, or just die of old age in a few decades from now. There is so much stigma and taboo attached to the subject. In short, everyone wants to avoid talking about it. The goal of this article is to remove all the fear behind it and talk about this difficult topic in the easiest and pleasant way possible to swallow it down your throats. First point, learn to enjoy the now, but do not become an instant gratification addict. We tend to think there will always be a tomorrow and thus end up forgetting about the brevity of life. It only when a loved one passes away that we remember that we are all going to die one day. But a few days after the funeral of your loved one, everyone goes back to their daily routine and then this reminder of the fragility of our lives vanishes from our mind. Second point, learn to be happy with who you are and what you have already achieved in this lifetime. I'm not asking you to stop trying to improve your life or accept a life of mediocrity. Life has its ups and downs, but that doesn't mean we can find happiness and joy at this very moment, even if we haven't achieved all of our goals. Third point, accept that you might not achieve all your dreams in this lifetime. I'm not sure if I will live long enough to visit some English castles in Britain or to become fluent in Latin in order to be closer to my Roman ancestors. Regardless of what I will be able to achieve with the time I have left in here, do not waste your time trying to become a jack of all trades. When I was younger, I used to waste too much time trying to be good at several things at the same time. This is the main reason I recommend you to pick only one or two skills goals and focus all your energy and will for the next 40 years of your life if you want to master them. A jack of all trades may know a little bit of everything, but unfortunately this comes with a big cost. He will never master any of them. Fourth point. Prepare a will for your loved ones and leave a message for them. If there is something or several things you wish to tell your loved ones before you go to the other side, I recommend you write all of these things in a letter and ask someone you trust such as a close friend of yours or a trustable lawyer to give it to them whenever you pass away. A lot of people never stop to think about leaving a will for their loved ones, especially their children, and this can be detrimental for the future of your children and your family. I'm not sure how US laws are about this subject, since I only lived there for a few years, but at least here in Brazil, a lot of times children or young adults who just lost their mother or father become screwed up, thus losing part of their inheritance thanks to an older brother or smartest stepmother stepfather who takes advantage of a lack of a will. All of this could have been avoided had their parents left a very clear testament. Even if you are still a young man, make sure to at least start thinking about making provisions to not let this happen to your loved ones. After all, it can be detrimental for their future well-being. Fifth point, Make amends peace before you leave this realm. If you ever had a fight or done something wrong with someone you deeply cared for and regret doing so, it time to grow some balls and ask for forgiveness from that person. If they ghost you or they don't accept, it their fault and the burden will be with them. You did your part, so you can feel relieved. Sixth aspect, accept that death is inevitable in nature law. As of right now, we have yet to be able to put a brain in a pot and make it work. And even if we do that, I ask, is it really worth extending your life beyond your biological expiration date? The idea of me living 200 more years stuck in a pot connected to a supercomputer doesn't sound like living at all. I'd rather not to try to prolong my time in this planet if I can live it fully. Seventh point, accept the fact that death may come unexpectedly. Wars, unexpectedly health issues, accidents, and natural disasters all play a part. This is an unfortunate reality of life. Even if you are young, you are at risk of dying. This is why I ask you to make an effort to enjoy every moment, even if your life isn't perfect. Tomorrow may be your last day. Eighth and last point, do not be afraid when the Reaper comes. Do not be afraid when the time comes to leave this realm. Be proud of all your personal, biological and financial achievements. You will still be able to watch the future of your loved ones and legacy in heaven. As a conclusion, life has its ups and downs, but still, this is no excuse for not using our time in here properly. Since none of us have a crystal ball to know which day the Lord will call us back to his palace in heaven, I want you to make a promise that from now on you will try your best to stop complaining about your current situation and start thanking God for giving you the power to live one more day. Every day is a blessing. We all have our sad stories to tell, but it's quite important for us to make an effort to improve ourselves every day until we find ourselves 6 feet under.
And that is it for now. If this content was entertaining and interested you, please share, like, and subscribe to this channel. I am the Swan, leading men till dawn, and even beyond. Thanks for the audience.